Downhill racing is pretty much one of the most dangerous sports in the world. High reward, but it's high risk. You against the mountain, looking for speed, and it's the best 2 minutes you'll ever have in your life. Better bring your tidy whities.
Some people think that we're a little bit crazy, you know, but we're prepared for it, usually. And when it pays off and you're standing on top of the podium, it's priceless.
Three elite downhill racers are taking a raft down the river. Stop me if you've heard this one.
Coming into another little drop.
Dropping.
Nice. Captain Moe.
Special to have Daron Rahlves and Marco Sullivan up here. Daron's a legend. He won like 13 World Cups, and he's a world champion and X Games champion, and Marco's a World Cup winner, and he knows the feeling that you have when you win is something that you can't even explain to people.
White eyes flying on the line, burning trails through the dark in the dead of night. Heartbeats pushing through the rain, losing time on the rails, we'll forget the pain.
Marco knows another feeling, though, and it's just as tough to describe.
Landed off a jump and just caught an edge, got spun around, smacked the back of my head. Boom, I woke up in the hospital. It was like, I had no idea what happened. Didn't know why I was there. Clicked on YouTube and it had like 80,000 hits. I was like, wow, must have been a good one.
Hanging out with Mo, the guy that is the best in the world and wins the Olympics, the energy, you know, rubs off.
Everybody's got to have an idol, whether it's free ski champion or a World Cup downhiller or a half pipe winner. I'm glad to be one of them for those guys back in the day.
What's up, Tommy?
What's up, guys?
Yeah, Mo.
What's up, buddy?
Tommy Moe actually being a guide here. Hopefully the golden moment rubs off a little bit from Mo to Marco here. And you never know what, you know, life experiences actually change things.
Good to see you, buddy.
You too. Welcome.
It's Tommy Moe. It's like an Olympic gold medalist.
Getting ready for a big week. Summer and winter in the same trip.
This is Chugach Powder Guide's Kings and Corn Camp in Alaska's Tordrillo Range. Vacation for big mountain fishermen, but this week it's a meeting of the minds that collectively have seen speeds that would make even an F1 driver pucker. Skiers have a term for corn. It's called hero snow because just about anyone can lay a turn into it and feel like they have a World Cup win or two of their own.
We were all racers, but now we're all really just free skiers having a good time out there making turns. And go out there and just lay your own artwork on a white canvas. That's what it's about.
There's some runs I would just wish it would never end, you know? Just when you go down the mountain, just life escapes you. It's back there, and you're in the moment, just looking ahead. Racing was that way for me too. Like, when I had the best race days, I felt this incredible flow. You know, I wouldn't like think about what I wanted to do, I wanted to feel what I was gonna do.
Been a really nice break from my reality. Come out here with a couple of my idols, not in the downhill course, but it's good for me to just pick the brains of Daron and Tommy and talk about skiing and life and just learn their secrets and tricks that they did. These guys have really stepped up on the toughest tracks in the world. The more time I can spend with them, the better.
I grew up fishing in Montana with my dad, and there's a lot of luck with fishing. You know, it's just like ski racing. You know, some days you're on fire, can't do nothing wrong, and then other days you kind of struggle, and because they'll snap you off.
Damn straight, Tommy.
Those guys were both on it. They both nailed it. They picked it up really fast, and I knew we'd get them with Daron and Marco because they're pretty competitive guys, and when you hook into one, it's like no other fish you'll catch in your life. Burn the candle at both ends in Alaska.
See the stars from where the birds make their homes, staring back.
I've even heli skied at midnight up here before.
Yeah. Different. Whoa. The distance perfectly projected endlessly. It's so, so beautiful.
Sunny day or a storm day, it doesn't matter. For me, it's about camaraderie. I love getting out there and ripping turns with my friends. And go hit some of this corn, right?
Corn o'clock.
Cornucopia. Feel it, really, right?